Hey, don't mind me. I just got out of the shower. What, you never seen me with my makeup off? Yes, you have. Well, maybe not as often, but still, we are on tour. You're gonna see me a lot more often in this state. I half expected my towel turban would scare you. It's easy to put on. I mean, I can show you one day, but trust me, my wet hair is pretty unruly. So, how'd you spend your night off? You wrote another song? What? Really? That's awesome! Well, it's just... Oh, no. Well, it's just... This was our one night off for quite a while, and I don't know about you, but this leg of the tour is killing me. You've got to be tired too, aren't you? Wait, you're right. You're always right. All right. Once that streak starts, you just got to go with it. No matter when or where it hits you. You're a writer, it's your day off too, and you spent it the way that you wanted to. Which was working. Not resting. You know, we gotta get better at that. Yes, you are way more productive than I give you credit for. Sorry. That's your songbook? Ooh, let me see. Come on, you can't just tell me you wrote a song and then not show me. What's it about? Love? Oh, yeah. Of course. No, well... love is so... broad. Oh, no offense. I don't mean that love isn't something that you should write about. But I don't know how you do it. It feels like all the songs nowadays are about love, whether lust or heartbreak, falling in, falling out, or something about being stuck in the middle. It all sounds the same to me. Perhaps what you wrote could break the cycle of it all? I wouldn't know unless you show me. Please? Oh, thanks. If your songbook doubles as your journal, you are in the hot seat, my friend. I'm kidding. Huh. I like it. No, really, I do. What inspired you to write it? Well, whenever I write, I get some sort of motivation that makes me want to start scribbling on the page, or I get a really good line in whenever somebody pisses me off or I'm just really fucking sad. And from the way I just read it, it sounds like something or someone is on your mind. Someone that you might not exactly be ready to tell how you truly feel about them. Did I get it right? No, really. I mean, we can really expand on this and make it bigger in the studio. I just want to know how I can help you take it further. How does this person make you feel? How often do you see them? Every day? Oh, maybe I know them then. Please. I don't have to be a detective to figure this out. We've been on tour for about 3 weeks now. And we do got a pretty big crew, but at the end of the day, we all get on the same bus and ride on over to the next gig. Huh. Think my hair's good now? Still wet, but more damp than anything. Now to hang this up to dry? Sorry. Look, all I'm saying is... why are you staring at me like that? Huh? A pen? Yeah, I mean... got one right on the nightstand. Like all these hotels do. And you know what? I think they've actually been improving over the years. It's no more of those, like, you know, dumb sticks that dry up so quick. Some of them actually click. Wait. See? That's what I'm talking about. Something I said must have sparked something in you. Oh, you're already done? What'd you write? That's your song. All right. and that's my name on top of the page, above the lyrics. Hold on. Wait a minute. I'm gonna wash my face. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna go wash my face. Cause I don't know, what if I'm that kind of person that doesn't wash their face in the shower? What if I forgot? Or I just wasn't in the mood, but I'm really in the mood right now. What? Maybe, I'm a very particular person. Maybe I should take another shower. Yeah, just in case, so I don't miss anything. Yeah, a cool, cold shower. It's really hot in here. Is it just me? Calm. I am calm. You're the one that's flustered. What are you talking about? This is a perfectly normal reaction to learning that a fellow band member wrote a love song about you. This is nothing. This is nothing. Nothing to worry about. Nothing to worry about. There is nothing to worry about. Do you realize what you've just done? We've been working together for years. We've been doing so well, album after album, and now all of a sudden we go on tour and you're gonna have feelings for me? You're gonna put me in that uncomfortable position where it looks like I friend-zoned you when that doesn't even fucking exist. It's just some made-up terminology to put the blame on the other person and mask the resentment of getting rejected when you never had it in the first place. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're going to say that. They always say that. I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. I can't do this. I can't. I just fucking can't. What? Would you stop? Could you just stop? Are you even listening? I don't love you. I can't love you. Yes. I am cold, because I have to be. How else are you going to get the point? But why? But why? 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 Everyone wants to know why. I don't know why. We just can't, okay? I don't feel that way about you. Not because I don't like you. I just don't feel love. I don't feel anything. Look, of course you don't understand. You write these songs because you feel something, right? You express those feelings and they come out as words and affections, and I do that too, but I've never actually done that. I've only ever written what I think it's supposed to be. Oh, come on. It's easy. If I could write a song about falling in love, I wouldn't. Because why should I remind myself of all the times I fell for you? Haven't you thought about how you hurt me? Don't you remember what you said to me on the car ride home back to your place, baby? I want to love like other people do, but not really. I want to love and not worry so much. I don't understand how they don't feel the same, or why I keep calling out your name. Sometimes I'm ashamed of you, but that could change soon. Sometimes I'm ashamed of you, but that could change soon. I don't know what you call it. Of course it's not just you. Fucking Christ. You really think I would just say that to make you feel better? You know, growing up, I was just so sick of everyone. I still am of how they tried to shame me for wanting to be alone or to guilt trip me into thinking that I need someone by my side, someone to call me mine, but I don't even feel anything. I never did then, and I don't now. And I know for sure that I don't want anything from anyone, ever. And you're not going to be that exception. I don't even know why you would feel that way for me. No one ever has. No, not one. Not one. Don't tell me. You've written well enough. Please don't be like one of them. That'll only make this worse.
Oh, if you never had it before, how do you know for sure that you don't want it?
I don't owe you anything. I don't need to prove anything to you. And if I know anything about being a woman, it's that I don't have to snatch at every form of affection you throw at me. I'm not desperate. Because I don't need it. Punishing myself? I'm not punishing myself. Who are you to tell me anything? I know that I can survive being alone. I find comfort in not needing it. Is that too much for you? Look, you and I both know we're not always strictly business. That's not how this band started. I wouldn't want it any other way. Please, I don't want to ruin this. Please, don't ruin this. Whatever it is, just could you respect that? Okay? Okay. Okay. I think I should, go back to the bus now. I'll be fine. I've done it before. Sleeping alone is a lot more comfortable anyway.